in my over 28 years of preaching, I've been blessed to preach everywhere in this country. And I'm not bragging, I'm just telling you, I ain't never asked for an invitation. You know why? Because when God knows you're a servant, He just sees you. Oh, you better act right now. This brother got some pull in the brotherhood. He ain't got nothing God didn't give him. You know, I was watching Tony Evans' wife's funeral, and her son did the eulogy. And one of the things that struck me about what he said was, he said, we prayed for an answer. And he said, oftentimes we don't want the answer. He said, but I realized a few days later that God gave us the answer. He says, if I leave her here, she has life. But if I take her home, she has life. She's got life wherever she is. Amen. And that's the problem with Christians. We don't walk like we have life. We walk like death is the end. We have to know that if God takes us home, it's life already. Amen. Our life is just here. What you see here is not life. Matter of fact, you're not even looking at you. You're looking at the shell of you. That's why when you leave, we can have a funeral. Woo, you didn't catch that, did you? When you leave, we can have a funeral. Notice, when people die, they don't say the person, they say, who has the body? You go from being you to a body. Hey, let me give you a disgusting example. You ever seen a cockroach that you didn't kill and you didn't pick up? You know why you walk to that cockroach and not jump in the air? It's because you know that cockroach is just a shell. And that blood is dead, amen. I don't feel the shell. Life is gone. Oh, sad, break this thing down, something like that. don't look like you don't understand what I'm saying. Praise the Lord. We almost know. Look what the Bible says. The Bible says he did this so the people of Israel would repent of their sins and be forgiven. We are his witnesses. Underline that phrase. Bible says we are, as we are, the apostles, are what? His witnesses. The word witnesses is martus in Greek. It literally means a legal standing where a person has seen and will verify the truth of that statement. What is he saying? In essence, we are the ones that have heard the life, we are the ones that saw the death, and we are the ones that saw the resurrection. And nothing you can tell us is going to change our minds. So based on that, we know that God came so that Israel can be forgiven of their sins. Now he's going to spread this beyond the border of Israel, but for now, Jesus came to save the lost sheep of Israel. But here's what he says. He says, we are witnesses of that, and so is the Holy Spirit, who is given to those who obey him. Now, if you're not obedient to the gospel call, guess what you're going to get? You're going to get the Holy Ghost. You don't have to worry about flipping over people. You don't have to worry about doing the happy dance. When you obey God through obeying the gospel, the rhema of life, the Lord gives you something called the Holy Spirit. He gives you himself. And at the end of your days, when you die, you and God are going to meet God. And when you and God are going to meet God, you're going to be judged by God, who gave life to God, who gave you God. Amen. Somebody. All of the works together. Praise the Lord. Then he says, when they heard this, the high council was furious and decided to kill them. But one member, a Pharisee named Gamaliel, who was an expert in religious law and respected by all the people, stood up and ordered that the men be sent outside the council chamber for a while. Then he said to his colleagues, men of Israel, take care of what you are planning to do to these men. Some time ago, there were a fellow Thaddeus or Thaddeus who pretended to be someone great, and 400 others joined him. But he was killed. Then he also talks about another man by the name of Judas of Galilee. They followed him. They too were killed. He says in verse 38, he says, so my advice is leave these men alone. He said, let them go. And here's the thing. Even though Gamaliel was not a Christian, and even though he probably was not inspired to tell the truth, the Lord used him to tell the truth anyway. Yeah, he did. Let me show you. He says, let them go. If they are planning and doing these things merely on their own, it will soon be overthrown. He says, but if it is from God, underline this word, you will not be able to overthrow. Isn't that something? Even the Jews understood. He says, now if you think this thing is not from God, don't worry about it. You know why? It's not going to come to pass. He says, but if you fight this thing, and it is of God, you fight against God himself. Some scholars believe he's referring to, I think it's 2 Chronicles chapter 12, verse 13. But what he is showing here is the fact that what you do is either going to be against God or for God. And what we have to do is be on the right side of history. When God calls us home, each one of us individually, he's going to ask, which side were you on? Were you fighting against me? Were you resisting the truth? When that preacher called you and you sat there and you were looking like, I don't care what they say, I ain't gonna change. I bet you think and said, well, you know what? He said it and I'm ready. And the Lord is coming back. And I don't know when. And I need to get my life right because I'm not living right. I think I'm gonna do that today. just myself. He that believeth not shall be damned. You only got two choices. What about next week? You only got two choices. What if I'm already baptized? You only got two choices. What if I'm in another church? Only one church. You gotta be in his body. You gotta be in his body. And I'm not saying this out of arrogance. I'm not saying this because I think we're the best. I'm saying this because God knows each one of us has to stand before him. And he came to seek and save the lost. Yeah. Guess what? You and I are lost. He makes that call. He's not going to go right now. Somebody's sitting here right now struggling. You're wrestling. You're saying to yourself, I'm going to come down. There's too many people. I don't know any of those folks. If I come down, I don't know what I'm going to do. Maybe I'll mess up.